Online question from our chat. We have a chat running right now of everything that's going on. What do we have?
Sonny would like to know, was that vampire really Bianca?
Was what vampire really Bianca?
The one that Armand saw towards the end of Armand.
Oh, I won't know till I write Bianca's story. And then I'll know. Yeah, it was Bianca. It was definitely Bianca. Why not say it?
Jason from Atlanta. What is your favorite city outside of the United States?
Rio de Janeiro. By far, Rio de Janeiro. That's a magnificent, spirit-ridden city. It's just fantastic.
This is Brian from Orlando, Florida. I'm a big fan, and tonight's my birthday, and I just wanted to ask you, the poetry that's in all of your books, is that done by your husband?
Well, a lot of times it is, and sometimes it's other poets. It's always named, though. If it's William Butler Yeats, there's his name on the poem. I think the quote in Armand is from the Bible. It's from St. John, I believe. And if it's from Stan, it's you know, Stan's name is with it. The poetry that's in the text, like if, say, the song or the poem out of the middle of Taltos or something like that, that's my writing. You know, the doggerel is mine.
Hi, Ann. This is Suzette. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana. And I'm just, woo, I'm from here.
I'm not taking a drink. Yeah.
My question is, I do a lot of theater as an actor and a director. Are you interested in seeing in any of your books going into a theatrical sense, like Interview or The Vampire Lestat?
Well, the problem with all my books is they're tied up in Hollywood contracts. When I signed those contracts, I didn't realize I'd be writing so many books with the same characters. And I didn't protect the sequels in the way perhaps that I should have, or I'm not sure that I could have. But the Warner Brothers owns almost all the vampires. In fact, it does own all the vampires, and it owns all the witch books also. And I have a difficult time, you know, dealing with them. They're not making any movies, and it's very much of a torment to me, and I don't think they'd let loose of any dramatic rights. So we do have someone right now who wants to use the dramatic rights to one of the novels, but it's not one of the ones I wrote under Anne Rice. Oh, it's Exit to Eden. It's a pornographic novel that I wrote as Anne Rampling.
Hey, mister.
Which is one of my favorite novels of mine, by the way. And it's a very good theatrical group. I think they'll do a beautiful job. They're very serious about it. They're not going to do what the movie of Exit to Eden did, and I will never mention that again. Any more questions?
Yes, Anne. I'm Pat from Dahlgren, Illinois, and I'd like to know which novel was the hardest for you to write.
Oh, boy, Violin. Violin and Cry to Heaven, those two that are most about music. Thank you. Those were really difficult. Those were like the you know, the pen was dipped in blood. I mean, it was agony to write those two. It was no fun at all. Like The Vampire Lestat, for example, was fun, you know.
Anne? Oh, sorry. This is Doris from Orlando, Florida, and I'd just like to know, which doll is your favorite doll?
Oh, my favorite doll is actually in my house. And my house, by the way, is open every Monday from 1 to 3 to the public for free. So if you want to come through, you're most welcome. It's at 1239 First Street. And you just have to show up between 1 and 3, and they'll show you through. But my favorite doll is there in the living room. It's a Brujune. And I've written about it in Taltos, and it's in the glass case. You can't miss it. It's in a beautiful blue dress. And it's standing by itself in this antique bookcase behind glass. I have many favorites, though. I love my dolls. It's crazy about all of them, in a way. I guess the Brujune, though, is the most beautiful. It's a French-made doll from 1890.
Anne, this
yes.
is Linda Sober from Oklahoma City, and I was curious if you have any plans of doing Cry to Heaven as a movie.
Well, Cry to Heaven is being made into a musical, and Robert Stigwood has got everything together with a wonderful librettist and musician named Matthew Wilder. It's one or the other. And he's also got a rock group that's very successful, Matthew Wilder, I think. And the music that Mr. Wilder has written is absolutely beautiful. It's unbelievable. It's really an opera, actually, is what it is. And we hope that will be out this October, this coming October, not after this one. This is the last day of October. Next year. And it's going to start in London in the West End.
And this is Michael from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. If you could spend some time with anyone, living or dead, who would it be?
Louis XIV and Peter the Great. That would definitely be who it would be. And if I could be born again as anybody, it would be the Russian Tsar Peter the Great.
Okay. Thank you, everybody, for your questions.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Take care.
Thank you, Anne. And thank you, everyone. Up next, we've got some good New Orleans pop from Dead Eye Dick, so stick around, and we're going on till they shut the AC off, which you couldn't tell it was on, could you? But it is. So we're going to be here all night, so stick around. We've got seating up there, 8th floor, there's food vendors, and there's some acoustic music down there. Damien Youth, you may remember him from playing in the past. Down on the 7th floor, we've got this dark, pounding gothic disco. You got to go down there and dance and join the freak show. So have a good time. We'll see you.
Rockin'.